pasé todo este llanto por nada. Ahora soy una chica mala. And now you kicking and screaming a big toddler. Don't try to get your friends to come holla, holla.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a, been waiting for this moment for a long, long time, fall makeup look. So first of all, I want to welcome you guys. For those who are new, my name is Nettie. And yeah, my name is Nettie. So don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And today we're going to be doing a fall makeup look. I don't know exactly which one I'm going to be, what palette am I going to be using. I just know that I was really, really excited for this. So on my Instagram, I asked if they wanted to see a smoky eye or a smoky eye or a fall look. And I got fall makeup look. So that's exactly what we're going to do. I said 7 o'clock. It's almost going to be dark. I'm wearing my bucked up shirt. And of course, I couldn't film without... These drinks have definitely took over. Starbucks who? Starbucks what? So, let's get started. I have nothing on my face right now besides moisturizer, and I primed it with this. That's all I have. I've done my eyebrows, which I probably should do off camera, because, and I've been struggling with these eyebrows since, I got the Morphe eyebrow pomade. Usually I'm using the Anastasia one, but that one dried out. And I wanted to try something new, but I'm so regretting this. So, and you know what's funny? I go ahead and line this up, right? And then I go back with the powder and I finish it because, like, okay, I am so smart. There's a reason why I brought you, so you can help. Like, hello. Oh, sorry guys, it's all up in your face. Should probably change him. All right. Yep, that's a little bit better. So, I don't know. You see what I'm saying? Like, I'm not even trying to be like, you know, rude or anything. But look at this. Like, how is a girl supposed to get her eyebrows done with this pomade? I'm just gonna do my eyebrows off camera and I'll come back when they're ready. Okay? So, okay. So I was thinking about what palette I should use, and this is like my fall palette. Like, I love this one. These are those colors with Katie and Desi Francation. Like, I mean, I mostly use this four colors here, and then I call it a day. But I don't even think they have this one available anymore. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is use a Jaclyn Hill, the first one. And then the first thing I'm going to go ahead and do is just set my eyes. You can set it with whatever you want. I usually use the foundation, but I don't feel like doing that today. So what I'm thinking I want to do, because for fall, I usually use like a lot of burgundies, a lot of browns, a lot of golds. That's what I usually use. But I'm going to go ahead and do a look that I used to do like back in the day. And I really, really love this look. The only thing is I use a different palette, but I mean, doesn't really matter what palette you use, you can use different colors. It's just the same technique that we're going to be using. So I'm going to go ahead and start with this warm color. It's called, girl, how did you put this? It's called Silk Cream. So we're just gonna focus on the outer edge. You see how I'm just going like this? And we're just gonna really focus right there. And then we're gonna start slowly bringing it down. Just on the corner. And I'm doing circular motions. And then whatever else is left, we're gonna start flicking it towards the center. Just like that. Then we're gonna go ahead and do the other side. And whatever's left, towards the middle. Now this is the brush 518. This is one of my favorite brushes, but I am gonna be switching a few brushes. We're gonna be using the 433. I really gotta wash these brushes. So this is a little bit smaller and it's more fluffier. So with this one, we're gonna go ahead and just pat it. And then once we pat it, we're gonna go ahead and go with the other one and then blend it. So for this one, we're gonna go ahead and start getting these two colors. I like to mix these. That is MFEO and Pukey. I don't know what that stands for. Oh, sorry, I'm so sorry. It was this one and this one that we're gonna be using. So this one is called Butter. And then we are just gonna apply it. We're not gonna blend it yet, we're just gonna start applying it. And it's just the outer corner. And start little by little and start, you know, building up. Because if you start with too much product, then it's hard to blend later. And it's just the same, just stay in the corner and then slowly start putting it towards the middle, whatever you have left. And then we're gonna do the same on the other side. And for this, I like to look straight at, I have a mirror right here. So I like to look at it so I can see exactly where my crease is. Okay. And then whatever's left. Then we're gonna go back with the first brush and then we're just gonna go ahead and make sure that there's no harsh lines. And I'm not going with any extra product, just whatever else, whatever it was there. I'm just going to go ahead and use that. There you go. Now, this is unnecessary, but I usually like to use a smaller brush like this to go ahead and start applying a darker color. I use something like this, or I also like these ones. You can use either one. They both do the same, but I feel like with this one I'm a little bit more precise, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this brush, and it's just like this. I'm gonna go ahead and go with the color Pukey, this one right here. I'm just went like this. I just patted it. I didn't like draw or anything like that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing. And I'm just gonna go ahead and keep this on the crease, right there. And then whatever's left, bring it down towards the corner. Create like a little triangle right there. And do the same thing on the other side. And then just go ahead and build that to your liking. I like to have it medium coverage. I don't like it the... I like it where you can see the different colors and not just one color. Okay. Then I'm gonna go ahead and go with this color. I'm gonna mix this one. I think I want to mix this one right here and this one. I'm gonna mix these two just because I want to give it a little bit. I want to start bringing the little red to it. The red one is called Jack's, and then the other one is called Firework. Okay, so we are having Jack's and... I'm sorry, it's not Jack's. It's Hunt's and Jack's. And I'm going to be using the same brush, and you're going to see a big difference. So with this one, I do like to tap whatever axis is there because it's going to be pretty strong since you mix it on those two colors. And then you are just going to start applying it on the actual lid, like this. See that? Whatever's left, start bringing it towards the middle. And then I like to clean it. Then I'm gonna go ahead and go with this brush with the little one. This one's like the 433, but just a little bit skinnier. And I'm gonna go with the first color that we went with. And then I'm just gonna start putting it towards the front. Just start dragging it. You really can't tell, it's just putting all the colors together. I know that looks super, super messy. That's okay. We're gonna go back with this one, and I want this color to actually be darker. So I'm gonna go ahead and go with Roxanne. And I'm just gonna apply what we already had did on the outer of my lid. I'm gonna go ahead and go over a little bit with that color, the transition color, so we can blend it. And I'm just applying it with this, okay? We're not blending it, we're just applying it. So I'm just doing tapping motions. So we are doing. Go ahead and go with the fluffy one, and then we're gonna go ahead and start blending. I totally didn't plan this. I just start growing colors and I'm like, ah, we need more of this, we need more of that. Okay, so I always like to leave the inner corner like this because we're gonna start going with shimmers. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab a flat brush like this, and I'm gonna use my favorite color, which is this one right here, that is called Silk Cream. I'm gonna go ahead and apply that, and then I like to wet my brush. Look. See that? Okay, and I like to just go ahead and tap. There. Then what I'm gonna go ahead and do next, I'm gonna wipe this down. Then I'm gonna go with a color. Crownapple, which is this one. It's like a shimmer red one. It's really, really pretty. We're just gonna go ahead and go. And then I'm gonna put this right in the middle. And start dragging it towards the end. And then I'm gonna start tapping it right there where the other one was, so I can nicely blend. This is really beautiful color. I'm really not a summer type of girl. I don't really like the heat. I like to be indoors with the AC on. I don't like camping. I don't like any of that. Like, I'm just not an outside person whatsoever. But I feel like this is the first summer that I actually appreciated the summer. And I wouldn't mind if it stayed a little bit longer. I mean, it's pretty hot, but I wouldn't mind. And then if you feel like it needs a little bit more, you can always go back to the other color. Just tap it. You don't need to wet it because it is a very intense color. And then you just go ahead and start blending it, flicking it towards this way. And then I like to clean it in between every time I go back to the palette, just so I can keep it a little bit cleaner. Now, do I do that all the time? Definitely not. I get lazy, so I don't do that all the time. So you can even like this, you can put eyeliner, you can put your lashes, but I'm gonna leave it like this. I'm gonna go ahead and go with the dark color. I'm gonna go with, this is called Hilster. It's really, really beautiful brown, the same one. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply it at the end. That is just gonna darken the outer corner. Okay. And then I like to go back with the fluffy brush and then start blending everything out. Okay, then one thing I go ahead and do, because as you can tell, this Jaclyn palette is one of my favorites, but it does have a lot of fallout, which is okay because the colors are amazing. I go ahead and I wipe it with a makeup wipe, and then I'll go ahead and put primer, and then I'll go ahead and put my concealer and do all the other good stuff. So one thing I'm going to go ahead and do is put my eyeliner first and then put my lashes, and then I'll be back once I have those on. Hey guys. So I went ahead and put my lashes. I'm wearing Sibley Lashes Style Insta Babe. These are one of my favorite lashes. And then for liner, I just honestly used some powder eyeshadow and then I applied it with this brush. And that's what I did. I didn't feel like doing anything else. So, yeah, I'm wearing this Insta Babe. I love how fluffy these honestly are. Well, anyways, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started on the rest of my face. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and spray my face. I always like to spray my face after I put like the actual cream powder. Not cream, yeah, cream. This is cream, duh. So after I go ahead and do that, I go ahead and spray my face. I let it dry. Then I go ahead and start concealing. I'm going to go ahead and use my Tarte concealer. I'm in shade light medium. And I apply it right here because your girl doesn't have the perfect skin. And I go ahead and I apply it in the little parts that I don't like. I use my brush. this brush right here and I start dabbing it. I used to use a beauty blender, but I feel like I was breaking out a lot with it. I used to clean it often, but I feel like you really can't get underneath all the sponge, you know, do like a full nice cleanup. So that's what I do instead, I just use the brush. So I went ahead and did that. Now I'm gonna go ahead and apply this one. Just apply a little bit right here. And then today, I'm not gonna be using like an actual foundation because in the winter, I don't use foundation. I don't use cream foundation. I usually don't. I usually use the CC creams in the spring and summer because it has some sunscreen. But in the winter, I don't. So I only do spot correcting. Then I am gonna do my contour because we have to. For this, I use this little brush. This is by e.l.f. It's called small stripple brush. And I just use it on a little bit on the actual spoolie and put it from the actual product because it's a little too much. Then I put whatever's left in my hand because look. And then I start contouring. I first do a line and then I start doing circle motions, blending it towards up. And then I do my chin. We're gonna make that look skinny. I grab little by little, and then whatever's left, just tap it up on the back of your hand. There you go. Then you go whatever's left on the forehead. Then from an eyebrow down, I like to do this. And then blend down and on the bottom of your lip. It will give like an effect that's a little bit more fuller. I have this little highlighter stick that I'm just gonna go ahead and use. I'm gonna use this brush. It's supposed to give you like a natural glow, but because it's the fall, we usually like to go for a matte skin. But remember, when your face is matte, you can see all your defects. So I like to keep it a little bit glowy so it looks like my skin is healthier than what it actually is. Then I'm going to go ahead and go with the Too Faced foundation. And I'm just going to go ahead and set my face. I only do this and then pat it. Then on right here, because we did do the contour, I'm gonna make sure I grab some and I stamp it going down my nose. And you can clean your cheeks if you want. Then I'm gonna go ahead and go with the bronzer. I haven't used this one in a long time, so I'm gonna go ahead and use it today. It's the Lisa Frank. For blush, I'm gonna go ahead and do this Seraphine. And I'm using products that have a little bit of shimmer, so that way my skin doesn't look too dead. Okay. Then before I go ahead and set my face and put highlighter, I do wanna do my under eye. With this, you have to be careful because remember, Jaclyn Hill does have fallout. I'm gonna go with the red, and I'm just gonna go ahead and stamp it on the bottom. So the way that I go, I put it and then I move it a little bit. I'm gonna go with the darker color and I'm gonna stamp it towards the end. Just like that. Then I'm gonna go ahead and set my face. And when your face is still a little bit wet, we're gonna go with the highlighter. I usually use the Ofra, but today I'm gonna use Wet n Wild, just so I can show you. This is a really good highlighter. See that? So I'm gonna go ahead and use a pointy brush like this, dip on it, and I'm gonna put it in the inner corner. And then I also like to put it on the high of my eyebrows. And then with the smaller brush, I just go ahead and blend it in. Now to finish it with the lips, I found a really nice nude. I'm gonna go ahead and use it, but first I'm gonna go ahead and line up my lips with the Essence Stay 8 Hours Lip Liner Waterproof. This is in color. Oh, it doesn't have one. Now I'm gonna go ahead and use my nude, and this is called This Is a Nude Legendary. I like to clean my beauty mark. And then another thing I've been using these little scrunchies instead of using regular rubber bands.
One, because it doesn't hurt my head. Like, I don't get headaches. And two, it doesn't create lines in my head. I watched, I think it was Jaclyn's Hill, Amazon, you must have. And she mentioned that. And I went to Ulta and I picked up a pack of two. It's like a suede pink one and then a fluffy black one. And I've been obsessed with it. So, yeah, I definitely recommend it, especially if you're barely tender-headed like me. That's a must. You have to get it because it's life-changing, like, for us. It's life-changing. So, yeah, guys, this is the final look. I'm sorry, I'm just cleaning up because after this, I'm going to be doing a video that it's long overdue. So, yeah, guys. This is the final look. I'm so excited. Can't wait to start wearing more looks like this. So, yeah, let me know if you guys want to see more makeup looks, if you guys want me to do story time. I don't know what you guys would like me to do. But just go ahead and please let me know. And, yeah, if you made it to the end, thank you for sticking with me. So don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Until next time. Bye.